under the ground. There's a gloopy black liquid there to be found. It's all that remains of life from around 100 million years ago. It's crude, crude, crude oil, crude. To make crude useful economically, we ship it in a tanker to the refinery and separate it by distilling fractionally, which starts by vaporizing it. Well, the bitumen condenses at the bottom where it's hot. The fraction's getting thinner the higher they got. The alkanes with the shortest chains of gases at the top uneasily combust. Bang! You get gas in plastics and lubrication, fuel for energy and transportation, medicine, solvents, and tar for roads. It's so darn useful, we use it loads. It's crude, crude, crude oil, crude. We get many heavy alkanes, many more than we need. Cracking breaks them up and then we get some alkenes. The double bond allows us to do more chemistry, synthesizing molecules. By rearranging atoms we get new properties. We can link them into polymers, and where would we be without the many plastics we use regularly, like polythene and PVC? You get gas in plastics and lubrication, fuel for energy and transportation, medicine, solvents, and tar for roads. It's so darn useful, we use it loads. It's crude, crude, crude oil, crude. Oil slicks kill birds and fish, and plastics won't decay. The CO2 from burning it is causing climate change. It's running low, so we must save it if we want to keep on making gas and plastics and lubrication, fuel for energy or transportation, medicine, solvents, and tar for roads. It's so darn useful, we use it loads. It's crude, crude, crude oil. Yeah.